وسنيسره للعسرة. Speaking, he has used these ayah to explain the hadith about the one who should not depend on qadar, rather he should strive. I'm giving you various examples which I'm sure you know of. Point being, if Umar misunderstood and the Sahaba were present, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would have explained that this is a misunderstanding, Umar, about the ayah. But he didn't. He acknowledged the understanding. However, he said alayhi salatu wasalam, by him in whose hand lies the soul of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you did not hear better than them what I just said. Now, you did not hear better than them what I just said. Now listen, Qatada added, Allah brought them back, between parentheses, momentarily. Allah brought them back in order to make them hear as means of scorn and belittlement, so that they will feel regret and remorse. See how they understood it? Allah brought them back momentarily, just so they will hear this belittlement, this scolding from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to increase them in regret. So this is what? An exception to the rule. An exception to the rule. You don't believe me? Let me give you another supporting evidence for that. Ibn Umar narrated the same incident, which is also found in Bukhari. And in that narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, verily, at this moment, they hear what I'm saying. At this moment, now only, they hear what I'm saying. When they went back to Aisha, and they told her the story, Aisha said, verily, what the Prophet ﷺ meant was, now they know that what I used to tell them is the truth. Then she recited, verily, you cannot make the dead hear. إِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَ. So now Umar and Aisha, both are of the understanding that the ayah mean, you cannot make the dead hear. So after she explained what happened, she commented. She referred to the ayah, that this is an exception to the rule. If someone wants to go against Umar and Aisha, then this is their business. But this is deviance. These are the Sahaba. And we don't know of a Sahabi who understood otherwise. We don't know of a Sahabi who understood that all the dead hear. So now they want to go against the Sahaba. If you go against the Sahaba, you're on the wrong path. That's not the path to Jannah. The path to Jannah is obeying Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to the understanding of the early generations, with the Sahaba on the top of the list. You go against these, you're gone. You're gone. But you will not be going where you want to go. That's the first hadith which they quote, and they use it as an evidence for their deviance. There's another hadith. The hadith of Anas radiyallahu anhu wa arda. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that when the deceased is placed in the grave and buried, and then the companions, the people who are with him who bury him, he hears the shuffle of their feet as they walk away, then the two angels will come and make him sit down and ask him. So they say that the hadith mentions that the deceased, once he's put in the grave, he hears what? The footsteps, the shuffles of the feet of those who are walking away. What do we say about this? What we said about the first? Do they hear them speaking? Don't they make dua? Is it in the sunnah to say, Allahumma thabbithu inda su'al? Oh Allah, give him firmness at the time of the questioning. Did the hadith say they hear what the people are saying? No, they strictly only hear the shuffle of the feet of the people as they walk away. Khalas. Two exceptions to the rule. And you must understand the hadith in the light of the Quran. Because Allah told us in Surah Al-Imran that the kitab, fihi ayatun muhkamat, hunna ummul kitab, wa ukharu mutashabihat, فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله. In the Quran which Allah sent down, there are ayat which are firm, entirely clear. And they are the mother of the book. And others that are ambiguous, that are not entirely clear. Then Allah told us, those who have deviance in their heart, they will follow the ayat and the ahadith which have more than one interpretation. Why? Seeking fitna and seeking false interpretation. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said concerning this ayah, when you see these people, as that Allah Azza wa Jal described, When you see them going after the mutashabih, know that these are the ones whom Allah described in the Quran, so be careful of them. He was warning us against someone who will get a hadith that is an exception and generalize it over everything in Islam. He will ignore the ayah, ignore the hadith, ignore the tafsir of the sahaba, because now his mind wants to accept this one hadith. Allah said, these are the people in whose hearts there is what? Deviance. Clear? Beautiful. طيب. So that puts an end. They cannot hear. طيب يا أخي, they cannot hear. Let us go back to the most basic of things. Can you call on to someone besides Allah? Is this something that Islam allows under any circumstances? Forget about the shrine. Forget about traveling to the location. Forget about who is in the grave. Let us just go to the most basic level of Islam, the thing with which we entered this deen. Does Islam allow you at any point in time to call on to anyone but Allah? La wallah. Wallah, we don't know of any evidence for that. Nowhere in the world. Now Allah tells us about this. Calling on the dead is the biggest kind of shirk. This is the thing which Allah will never forgive if the person dies in that state. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Allah will not forgive that someone will associate partners in worship with him. No. وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. He forgives whatever is lesser than that to whomever he wills. But if you die in a state of shirk, no Jannah. No Jannah for you. Now let us see. These people say, look, we are calling on these dead people and you are saying what we're doing is shirk, like the kufr. It's kufr like the kufr of Quraysh. But the Quraysh were kuffar. They didn't have La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. We have La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. We worship, we do this, we do that. How can you say we are like them? We say, look, why are you calling on these people? What is the objective? Do you believe that they control the earth? What will they say? No. Some hardcore among them will say yes. But the average one will say no. What will they say? That we either want one of two things. Either shafa'ah, we want their intercession, that they intercede for us with Allah. Or what do we want? We want to seek nearness to Allah through them. They're like intermediaries between us and Allah. You say, this is amazing, man. This is the exact belief system of the kuffar. And these are the same two reasons they gave in the Quran. No one denied among the Quraysh that Allah is the Rabb. Right or wrong? وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they will say, Allah, the kuffar of Quraysh. They will say Allah, they had no doubt. But what was their issue? Here are their two issues. Allah told us, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. And those who have taken besides Allah protectors, helpers, they say, we do not worship them except so they can make us get nearer to Allah. The same exact things of the kuffar of Quraysh. And Allah said at the end of this ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي مَنْ هُوَ كَاذِبٌ كَفَّرٌ. Allah will not guide one who is a big liar, big disbeliever. He called them kuffar with this claim. We're not worshipping them, man. I'm not worshipping this man. I'm only trying to get near to Allah through this wali, this good saint, who's better than me. This is the same thing the kuffar said at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah did not accept that. Neither did his messenger. He fought against them. And that did not permit him to Islam. Believing in Allah being the creator did not permit them to Islam. They had to give up these false gods. They didn't. The second hujjah is what? Shafa'ah. And Allah says, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ